All right, welcome back to Let's Play Driver Minneapolis. This is the finale. We've gotten a lot of the game under our belts, and we've just got this last chapter of who knows what plot left. Are you excited? I know you haven't seen this before.
I'm excited and confused. This scene change was definitely an interesting narrative choice. You know, I actually
scene
thought that
change?
We had a lot invested
what?
In San Francisco.
San Francisco? What? Why the hell would anyone... game have you been watching? Dude, so, I mean, you know, I can sort of see why you'd want to make a game about San Francisco, because it has interesting terrain and, you know, some classic chases have been filmed there. But really, I think Minneapolis is a much stronger choice. There's just a lot more, you know, famous streets. Like, who doesn't know the I-94 tunnel? Who hasn't wanted to drive 100 miles an hour through that? And I maybe they'll do a sequel in San Francisco, and that would be cool and a bold decision, bold direction
for
them to take the series.
Or maybe you're just waking up from a coma right now.
What?
I know, your whole world's getting turned on its head. Well, let's see where it takes you.
I'm confused. So we're overlapping a bit from the last episode, right? This
yeah,
just doesn't repeat.
Just
again.
As a reminder.
Okay. Whoa.
Surrounding area, stay calm and evacuate quickly and in an
oh,
orderly fashion.
Crap.
We're told that no demands
been
have been
out
issued.
This whole
just that
time?
Ominous warning received a little over an hour ago that law enforcement officials have now confirmed came from Charles Jericho. We've just received a few more details from law enforcement officials.
Good thing they left that there
apparently
for him.
They are now confirming that we are dealing with some
oh,
sort of
no,
weapon.
This isn't happening.
Police are requesting that people
I wasn't
abandon
there.
Their vehicles as a way of expediting
wasn't there to stop
the evacuation
him.
Process.
Or not stop
this
him, as the case may be.
News, your eyes on the city.
Eyes on the city.
We need eyes on the city.
Oh!
Eyes on the city, Ray.
Whoa!
I gotta stop him.
I
yeah,
totally
I
missed
clever.
That.
I thought that was pretty clever. It was the TV news that had been filling his fever dreams or coma dreams.
Tanner, John, stay with the but the repetition of that buddy, phrase I totally missed.
Yeah.
Tanner!
I know you can hear me, Barker. I need you to fight.
Just a little longer.
Wait, so now he's... Now he knows it's a coma dream, but he's like, nope, I want to stay in this coma dream some more.
He's like, well, I almost killed Jericho in the coma. Maybe if I kill him in the coma, he'll die in reality.
Okay.
I don't think that's what he's actually thinking.
Give up, Tanner. Just relax.
Oh my god, he's purple now.
You want to fight Jericho? You've got it.
If you're dead, you won't have to fight me.
Screw you, Jericho. I'm not giving in. I'm never giving in.
Except for the part where I woke up from a coma and then chose to go back into that coma.
And we're just dumped right into the action. No,
I'm coming for you, Jericho. You hear me?
So this is a shift thing, right? Or are you locked into your car?
I don't know.
Ignore it. Keep going.
I get the feeling.
Try your party trick on me. You can come at me with half the cars in the city, Jericho. I'm still gonna take you down. I gotta get closer. Gotta keep up.
Losing him.
Yeah. Are you sure you're not supposed to do this by shifting?
No, you're almost definitely supposed to do this by shifting.
Okay.
I know, it's like the most deeply ingrained mechanic in this whole game, yeah. And I still always forget that it's available.
You know, game developers can't keep you down. They're
that's
like
true.
The man.
Exactly.
Offering you options of how to play their game such that you can possibly win it. And you're like, nah, screw you, man.
Bad move, Tanner. If you're here.
Ah.
Wake up the hospital room, the TV news, and then I'm back here. I must be sedated. Dreaming or in a coma.
The bastard's trying to run me off the road.
Seriously? Is that all you've got?
Oh, so they're not actually going to do the thing where if you jump out of your car, he takes over your body?
No, I'm surprised, though.
That would be a fascinating twist. I kind of wish they had done that. That wasn't even one of his cars that almost ran you off there.
I do have to keep the gap closed in my car occasionally.
It would be really fascinating if you could trick one of his cars into taking himself out. Like, position yourself, interpose the truck between his red car and you.
I need a crash card in here, stat.
Keep fighting, John. Keep fighting.
Keeping fighting.
That sounds like an achievement. Use his own weapons against him.
Hello, that would be awesome. Yeah.
This is my.
Oh, interesting. Always rules. Oh, no, it's just hearing voices.
Can't do this. Can't do that.
I know what's happening. I know this is some kind of dream.
You know, it's not a dream, Dad. It's a coma. You're dying.
So this is now clearly John talking to himself. Hey!
That was awesome.
You can do it.
Well, he didn't damage himself at all.
No, but he doesn't have a damage bar right now.
In my head? I didn't fix anything. Still.
What? Whoa. Oh, no, that's... Okay. I thought for a second that... He hit one of his own cars so hard that it flew into the air. But no, he's just going all Magneto on this shit right now.
Yeah. This is the most annoying chase sequence in the entire game.
Visually, really awesome, though.
Yeah, it is.
Dude, they must have pumped up the mass on his car right now to be like a sun. Like, I'm surprised the other cars aren't being pulled into the gravity given the impact he's hitting them.
That's funny. Oh, that one exploded in the air. That was cool.
It's a tanker.
How is he doing that? Oh, right. It's all in my head.
Very good, John.
Next coma, I want a yacht. Deep sea fishing and a goddamn yacht.
This is wonderful. Is the objective just to stay alive?
Focus.
I don't know.
For long enough? Because looks like the rubber banding is actually keeping you from catching him for the most part.
No, next coma, I'm having cocktails. On the beach, on my own private goddamn island.
So I'm sure that I edited out some of the attempts, but I think I spent a solid hour on this mission.
Huh.
As you can imagine, it doesn't take very many tankers landing on you.
Uh-huh.
And some of it feels kind of random.
Yep, the thing is you generally, you can tell the car's trajectories pretty well, but it's not always easy to see where, like...
It's gonna bounce,
like,
or how to get out of its way.
You can see where horizontally, if that makes any sense.
Yeah. Wow. Wow.
That's so cool looking, I don't care.
I know you're not built to take this kind of punishment, but you and me, we got history.
I enjoy it now, Jericho, because in the real world, I'm gonna break you.
Are you trying to get close enough to ram him?
I don't even know what I'm trying to do. I'm just staying alive right now.
We're doing the freeway face-off in reverse with flying cars.
Exactly.
You know this. Jericho's poison gas bomb doesn't make any sense. Too many hit! Where did he go? Is that it? Do I win? Where are you, Jericho? Man, it's not time this.
Alright.
Yeah, the objective was just chase Jericho there.
Sure. Visually quite impressive.
Miss me?
A few hours ago, I would have driven us both into a wall if there was a chance it would kill you.
Why'd they change your heart? Your balls drop off?
None of this is real. So what would be the point?
Has Jericho's hair grown back since the opening cutscene?
Breaking my face?
I don't know.
Cracking my ribs? Seeing me bleed? That's what you want.
Now we're in the Matrix.
Yeah.
So why don't you just do it?
And then what?
Then we do it all over again. Over and over until your knuckles split down to the bone. Or you fall all the way to the other side. You see, coma's just a pretty word for nearly dead. Who knows how much time you got left? I wouldn't waste another second.
This only works because the faces are so expressive.
Why don't we just kill each other?
Yeah.
Right now. You
son of a bitch!
That's more like it! What are you gonna do, though? Better do it quick! Smell of death in the air, Tanner!
He is Soul Blighter! Like, that literally just happened.
Now, yeah, for sure.
When I woke up in the hospital, it was all over the news. Some kind of chemical bomb or...
That doesn't sound like me.
Jericho's not a terrorist. It's not some vendetta or revenge plot.
Revenge sounds like your game, Tanner. I mean, who's inside whose mind here, right?
Yeah, it's not him. Please, they got the grammar right in the subtitle there.
Wait. Building a bomb. It isn't him. Having people think that there's a bomb is...
Brilliant.
It would clear out downtown. The city would be wide open. Shit, I gotta wake up.
Good luck with that.
Oh, come on. All right, come on. Come on, John. Wake up. Oh, wake up. Wake up, God damn it. God damn it. Wake up.
Hang on a second. Highway, in my head. Cars, in my head. Jericho, in my head. Okay, new rules. I'm throwing some goddamn cars too.
Yeah. Throw vehicles at Derek.
The rules have changed, Jericho. You're in for a shock. I don't think there's a therapist in the West Coast qualified to straighten this.
Why aren't you throwing more cars at him?
Bullseye!
I mean, did you see that? That truck landed square on top of
yeah,
him.
Yeah, but not
nothing.
With a lot of momentum. It just... the only...
Oh, yeah, because if a giant truck lands on you, but it only fell 3 feet onto you.
Well, yeah, because what counts is what it does to your... What it does to your momentum is how it sort of measures crashes, as near as I can tell. If you're going fast and it makes you stop, that hurts.
Yeah. Yeah,
so
but again, I dropped a motherfucking truck on him.
You need to pick up cars that aren't next to him, that are like, you know, 100 yards in front.
Or behind, maybe. I don't know.
Could be.
Ah, you're
see?
Going down, pal.
Oh, but he can teleport back in front of you if you pass him.
Eat metal, you lousy son of a bitch.
This is... I mean,
just
I
suck it up, John. I gotta get it.
It's sort of like a final boss fight,
looks
I
like
guess.
Looks like you're starting to fall, Tanner. I can almost hear the life support.
Worry about the respray later. What a...
This is totally weird and
come on, John,
difficult
dig deep.
To process.
It's all on the line.
That's doubly difficult to play. If the one where all I had to do was stay alive took me half an hour to beat, imagine how long this one was.
Mm-hmm. Well, you want to pick cars as far in front of him as he's picking them in front of you.
Highway.
Yep.
In my head. Cars. In my head. Jericho. In my head. Okay. New rules. I'm throwing some goddamn cars too.
Oh, and of course, he has incredible mass right now.
Bullseye!
That's part of why cars aren't doing
changed,
nearly
Jericho.
As much damage
you're
as you
in
expect.
For a shot.
Yeah.
Gotcha!
Oh, that one did a good amount.
You enjoy- don't pull through this and wake up. Hey-o! You're going down, pal.
It actually plays a little cutscene when you throw a truck at him.
Plays a little cutscene.
I'm taking you apart, piece by piece.
Sorry, fellow drivers.
Hey, they're not real.
Metal,
ooh, that was a good one.
Is that all you got, you sad son of a bitch?
Apparently, this guy's a son of a bitch.
Yeah. So you need to stop passing him so that he stops teleporting.
I don't think it matters, my relative position to him. I need to stay alive.
No,
and...
it does, because come when on, you John, pass him, frost. He teleports out of the way of the cars you're throwing, like in the middle of the throw. That just happened.
Fair enough. As if there wasn't enough for me to think about during this encounter.
You know what I think the problem is? You spent the entire game searching around to pick out exactly the right cars and stuff. And what you needed to do, and what would have trained you for this, is rapid shift. You know, the BB gun approach I described?
Yeah.
Just out shift. You know, shift hit, shift hit, shift hit, over and over again, and you'd be killing them. Hey, seriously, why are you waiting?
Because I gotta throw a pretty car
at him. Damn it! No!
Yes, he will know his doom is real if it comes in the form of a Porsche.
The car that I throw at him has to have good handling.
Uh-huh.
Hang on a second. The highway.
Do they actually... when you shift this time, I want to try and pay attention to... Do they still show you the stats for the cars?
I don't think that they do. Oh, they totally do.
Jericho, you're in for a shot. Holy shit. Why are you going that far? You're so bad at this. Oh my god. Ah, this is agonizing.
Into Jericho's hands, dummy. Wish I could hand over the controller.
Bullseye.
Although you're going to be playing this on your own, so you'll have to tell me. Yeah, I beat it on my first attempt.
I mean, yeah, I know I have an advantage because I know what's coming and stuff. But seriously, this does not look as nearly as hard as you're having trouble with. What are you doing? Like, you just spent 3 seconds contemplating, should I throw this tanker?
It's got bad handling.
No!
Oh, God. The last challenge does lose some of its charm when you've attempted it 7 times.
It can't be as bad as you're making it out to be.
Okay, new rules. I'm throwing some goddamn cars, too! Bullseye!
Haha, I made him go faster!
The rules have changed, Jericho. You're in for a shot.
Ooh. See, that looked good, even though you didn't get a little cutscene for it. Aw.
Stupid flying cars.
You know, I gotta say, as wildly different as this mechanic is from anything you've been trained to do before, I really like the way they, you know, taught it to you, in a sense.
Ah, you're going down, pal.
Yep.
Like, they did a good job of setting up and introducing... That fire was hovering in midair.
Just like real fire.
Yeah.
I'm taking your mark, piece by piece.
I set them into oncoming, too.
It is really fun when it works right.
Eat metal, you lousy son of a bitch!
Oh, come on. At least I'm not losing him yet.
Damn!
Looks like you're starting to fall, Tanner.
Oh, jerk. Double jerk.
I can take anything you throw at me, Jericho, and come back for more.
You're killing me.
Except for that second part, the come back for more part.
God damn it, no!
My sentiments exactly, Tanner.
I understand you're leaving this in to demonstrate how difficult this mission is.
I should probably remove some of these. I may, actually.
In my head. Cars. In my head. Jericho. In my head. Okay.
I'd start reciting his lines along with him, except that with the subtitles on, it's less impressive as a feat of memorization, you know?
Bullseye! The rules have changed, Jericho. You're in for a shot.
And that shock is that I'm going to chase you around, get hit by a lot of cars, and do a very small amount of damage to you. Are you ready for it?
He does take a lot of hits.
I get it. It's a boss fight. It wouldn't be a boss fight if you didn't have to try it like 10 times.
I'm assuming, though, that this can't be the final boss fight, because it's not Well, I'm hoping it's not the final gameplay in the game, as it were, because the game has been incredibly well designed up till now. And one of my least favorite things is when the final boss fight incorporates a mechanic that's totally alien to the mechanic it's been teaching you to master through the entire game. Yeah. Like, so this is fine as a run-up, but the boss fight ought to be, you know, a straight-up driving challenge, a race or something like that.
Although, perhaps in the case of this game, they've taught you that they're going to teach you a new mechanic every level.
But
it's been increasing in complexity.
You know, as a final boss fight, this is not a test of how well have you mastered. It is in some ways, it sort of is, but...
No, I'm with you. It doesn't feel like the right way. The most satisfying way.
Besides, it's not in the real world yet, so hopefully they will have some way of actually taking down in the real world. This is the final boss to get out of your dream. Oh my god, did you win?
I beat him. Now to be dead.
Hey, it's Sunny again.
Okay, John, wake up. Wake up, John, it's time.
It should just make me shift up. That'd be fine. It was like shift out and like zoom out, zoom out, zoom out, zoom out, and then I do it one more time and I wake up.
That would be cool.
Evacuation of downtown San Francisco. Local merchants are Jones. Worried that Tanner! Hey man, it is really good to see that you're...
Turn that goddamn TV off before I put a bullet in it.
That you're finally awake. Whoa! Hey, back in the bed, my man.
I need car keys.
You need pants. And I got bad news about your car.
Give me your pants. Jones, I need to move on this. I need to get downtown now.
You need to stay in bed. Look, you've been through a lot. You're not really making a lot of sense.
Don't talk to me like I'm crazy. Look, I know how this sounds. I'm not losing my shit. Oh, you gotta trust... You trust me, right?
Most of the time, yeah.
There isn't any bomb.
What are you talking about?
It's a diversion. Jericho's making a different play. Look, you gotta trust me. I know what's going on.
Fine. But you're gonna have to steal your own damn pants.
Thank you.
Oh no, we won't be in the iconic car for the finale.
Yeah.
Welcome back.
Alright.
I like that. That was a well-reasoned argument, so I'm gonna allow you to drive this car, having just woken up from a coma.
Okay, John, this plan isn't getting any smarter.
Law enforcement officials have once again repeated their call for all those remaining on your side of the road. Downtown area to evacuate immediately.
Oh, of course, because everyone's leaving the city, no one's heading in.
Details are scarce at this stage. What is known is that a potentially massive chemical weapon, I am quoting police sources here, could detonate in the city. Police officials have confirmed that a warning has been issued by escaped criminal Charles Jericho, but as of yet, he has made no demands. We are just receiving word that police bomb disposal teams are being withdrawn. We're being told to evacuate. This is... It's going to happen. Oh my god.
What?
I can see a huge cloud of gas. It's taller than the buildings. Moving fast. We gotta move. A huge wall of gas coming down the street. Run!
That wouldn't have been expected.
Yeah, kind of cool. Looking.
Static. The radio's dead.
He's not still in the coma.
Okay, still alive. Mm. It's not cyanide gas. It's a goddamn smokescreen. Why?
Because we haven't had enough fog in the game until now.
Downtown. What the hell does Jericho want downtown? Convicts. It's a prison break. He's at the goddamn prison.
Oh, right, from the opening cutscene.
Exactly. This is where
John.
The prison is. In San Francisco, by the way. South of Market.
Gotcha, you son of a bitch.
What's a crow doing there?
Crows exist in the real world, too, you know.
By the time the feds figure out this shitstorm, you'll be sipping mojitos, and they'll be chasing 200 psychos across the country.
What about you?
I'll be spending $30 million of your hard-earned dollars. Get out of here.
What is it?
The pain in my ass.
I recognize him from the car he doesn't ever drive. Seriously, how would he possibly know?
He would just assume.
But you can run, asshole.
Yeah, because no one else who's out in the city right now would possibly steal a car that didn't belong to them.
What are all these pedestrians doing here? I thought they were going to evacuate them.
They're the prisoners.
Jones?
Oh, shit. Oh, right, the radio static. There does need to be some sort of explanation for that. What, did he just set off an EMP?
Right.
What the hell? It's good to be back.
Well, I'm going the wrong way.
Yep.
Come on, come on! No, you do not get away! I did not wake up just to let him escape!
Oh, no!
No, no, no!
So you can't shift here, I assume.
That would be funny.
Yeah.
I wonder if we'll encounter some dialogue related to that.
Uh-huh. See, this is much more appropriate for an actual, quote, final boss thing. This is testing us up if they've been training you.
You're right about the boss.
Yep.
And they have increased the difficulty with, you know, the visibility and all the obstructions.
Selma heading south. Jones.
Ooh. Well done.
Thank you. That's the ballpark on the right.
Oh, great.
For just a
so this is interesting because without the shift mechanic, it's his health versus your health. You can't hit him without at least taking a little bit off of your own.
Hurts, don't it?
Oh, he has much less health than you, okay.
Oof.
And we're out of the smokescreen. I wonder what other twists they're gonna throw on this.
Reality has its drawbacks.
Oh, come on, please hurry. You could have taken him out right there. That would have been a perfect T-bone.
That was what he said when I attempted the shift, by the way.
I assumed, yeah. Oh, when you actually pressed the shift button.
I pressed the A button, yeah.
Yes.
Woo!
They set that up for you.
For me,
that was a special
specifically. Uh-huh. They knew, based on my play patterns, that I had to hit every ramp truck.
Take the hit, Jericho. Give up.
See, it's annoying that that doesn't cause him to lose any health, because I feel like I did architect that in some fashion, you know? Like, I forced him to hit that police car.
Which way is he going? Okay. Yeah, he's got... Okay, it is a health versus health kind of situation, but his health bar is much smaller now than yours and than his has been in the previous missions. When it was all through. Yes! This is one of my favorite shortcuts in the entire game.
Yeah, I love this one. Boom!
Man, the real world must have missed me.
Yeah, this is very appropriate last level, actually. It's pretty fun.
Oh no!
You can't turn? Turning, my only weakness.
Uh-huh.
Come in, John Tanner. Emergency services won't let anyone into the gas valve. It's history, partner. I am inbound. Where
come
are
on. Come on.
Oh, you have no boost! You have no boost!
No!
That was annoying. Oh well. The good news is he takes the same route every time, so I won't get fooled by that again.
Mm-hmm. You do have to start all the way at the beginning, though.
You can run, asshole!
I hadn't even noticed the lack of boost or ram until then.
Yeah.
That's tough.
got? Old news, partner. I'm in pursuit. Selma.
So even though the gameplay is, you know, Jones. Nothing special, they're Jones. Taking away a lot of the advantages you've learned to work with.
Yeah, it's kind of an interesting choice because they've been adding complexity and layering it on level after level, and yep. then for the final encounter they remove all
it's
of it.
It's just how good are you at driving? You've had the entire game to learn how to drive a car.
Yeah.
Fortunately, this car appears to handle okay. It's not super floaty like some of the other
yep,
some of the early game cars they stuck you in.
Nor is it a luxury car, it's like a solidly average car.
Yep.
Or like slightly above average.
Yep. I will never be not be disappointed by that missed opportunity right there.
I wonder if that did any damage to him. A little bit.
It did a little bit. His health bar flashed.
Land on him! Oh.
No, you always lose ground on racers when you go off ramps and stuff.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, the correct thing to do from a physics modeling standpoint.
Physics, who needs it?
Now that, I'm not sure whether you dealt any damage. Left.
Damn it.
Thought you were talking about how you learned the route.
I totally did say that. Oh, that was a convict. Oh, clever.
Not all the people out here are so convicts, but there are a lot of them.
The attention to detail in this game.
Whoa!
Awesome.
That's new.
Looks good.
Hold it together, John!
Yeah, and the evacuation means that the streets now are relatively empty of moving traffic, but full of parked obstructions. No, that's the same place you lost him last time.
Anyone in the gas left? Reporter, I am inbound. Where are you? Jones, I'm still in pursuit.
Oh, if you lose him again, I'm going to
be pissed. Looks like the docks.
Boost.
By the book, John.
Yeah, this is so... This is the moment where you realize, oh my god, I don't have a boost. But that's always what you do when you're, you know, falling behind like that. So what's Jericho's plan here? He's kind of doubling back on his route.
Well, he's driving into Hunter's Point, which is a legitimate bad neighborhood in San Francisco.
Yeah.
So he probably has a warehouse or, you know, a safe house or, I don't know, cronies.
Wait,
or something.
Hold on. You can hear Jericho inside Tanner's head whispering to him.
You sure that's not part of the song?
No, it sounds like Jericho whispering, "You're not good enough."
It
could be residual effects of the promo, maybe. I don't know.
No, you do not get away!
I'm surprised they didn't subtitle.
Oh, hey. You didn't have to... I wonder if there's a separate ending cutscene for taking him out before he reaches here.
Interesting. I hadn't thought of that.
Where is it coming from? And it's still in the world.
That's part of the song, I'm pretty sure.
If you say so.
Who's doing this?
Okay.
Who's killed us?
I guess... They probably specifically chose this song to go with this mission. Alright, Tanner. One last game of chicken. That'll determine who's the real man.
That's actually a very appropriate way to end, I would say. Game of chicken.
What? That's entirely the correct decision to make. From a writing standpoint, I mean.
Come in, dispatch, 40 Adam 30, requesting backup at the old warehouse, Hunter Point.
Yeah, that was a well-crafted ending.
Yeah. Also, I'd like to point out the old warehouse. You know, the one.
I had everything under control. Under control? And you were about to wreck my damn car. Now, can we please get that beer?
All right.
All units, suspect stolen vehicle heading at speed, Marin Ridge.
Dispatch, this is 40 Adam 30. We got this one.
Are you sure about this, John?
Yeah, I'm sure.
All right.
Dude, I'm like 15 minutes out of a coma now. I could totally take on this challenge.
No, it's far enough in the future that his car's out of the shop.
Oh. That's true.
This is actually a fairly good way of denoting the passage of time, I think.
Yep. So, did the ending catch you by surprise?
No, actually, it wasn't really. I thought it was just entirely... that was a well-crafted, appropriate ending. I think it's good that they didn't go for shock value or any massive twist. It was just a really... They hit the right dramatic notes. It was entirely thematically appropriate to have Tanner and Jericho facing each other in chicken, and then... Jones comes in and does the intelligent thing and actually, you know,
breaks it up.
Yeah. Like, that was correct. That ties into and neatly, I guess, ties a bow on the sort of theme of Tanner cracking up and, you know, losing track of police work versus justice versus revenge.
Yep. Of course, the, millionaire convict is still on the loose, right?
Well, yeah.
But at least we got
police definitely have their work cut out for them.
Wonder if there'll be a sequel.
Oh, of course there will. I don't know if it'll be a direct sequel, but I mean, well, I guess it's based on how well this game sold. But the Driver series has some momentum.
So we've got a few other videos coming up if you're interested in staying in the Driver universe. We're going to be playing some multiplayer, and the thing I'm looking most forward to, we're going to be tackling all the movie challenges, which is famous scenes from movies in San Francisco that we get to play out.
Yeah.
So don't go anywhere. Well, you can go anywhere right now if you want. Yeah. I mean, these credits
are
pretty long.
The credits do not take up the last 18 minutes of this video.
Oh, yes, they do.
Really?
Video game credits are kind of silly, though, because they've got the development team, which is, you know, 50 or maybe 80 people. And then they've got, like, everyone at the Ubisoft organization, who maybe does deserve credit for assisting, but was not directly involved in this game, you know?
Like, yeah. Okay, but 18 minutes of credits. Like, tell me they at least offer the option when you're playing the skip through. I understand why you want to leave them in for the sake of the LP, but really...
No, they don't even offer you the option to skip it. I could turn off my Xbox, presumably that would work.
Oh my god. that's obnoxious.
It is a little obnoxious.
Like, they're going really slow. Okay, well, time to talk. We have the option of either leaving this blank and saying goodbye, or, you know, saying till next later now, or talking about random shit for the 18 minutes while the credits roll.
Or, if there's anything else that we haven't discussed relating to the game at this point. Any other points you want to make on the topic of Driver San Francisco?
I'm disappointed they never came back to the woman who betrayed her husband and ran away with the money.
Yeah, some of those side quests were pretty fun. I wonder, do they ever implement story in the dares and challenges?
No.
Not really, huh?
No, they really, really don't.
No other way to encounter that. Yeah, that's true. I just really like the tone that this game had, you know?
Yeah.
Like, it was an excellent racing game, but more importantly, it didn't take itself seriously. I love that about it.
Yep. I mean, towards the end, it treated the material seriously. Actually, you know what? You know how we were sort of talking about how the coma storyline was much more dramatically compelling than the crime storyline?
Yep.
So they sort of had two separate final boss fights, and I was complaining from a mechanical gameplay perspective. The first one didn't really feel appropriate. But that was definitely the sort of the flashiest high point of the game, the craziest bit. And I think it works that that was what they used to cap off the coma storyline that we were actually interested in. But then the straight up, you know, here is a driving game, you know, purist sort of crime story had a very simple and appropriate final mission.
Yeah. Well, I think we should just wrap it up here, and we can discuss the game further in our multiplayer sessions if we're so inclined, or just continue enjoying this game world, because it's a really fun game world.
Hey, random question, as long as we're done talking about the real stuff. Did you ever see the movie that came out in the States last summer, Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy?
Nope. I haven't even heard of it.
Oh. It's based on a fairly thick, intricate sort of spy novel of the not James Bondy going and running around and shooting people, but the there is a mole in the organization. We have to figure out who. Lots of tense, guarded looks kind of stuff. Starring Gary Oldman.
Okay.
Who plays the main character as just incredibly reserved. Like, you know, he got to where he is in the spy organization because he is incredibly trained at never giving anything away with his face. And the movie skips around in time a lot. The reason I thought of it is, pardon me, the way you can tell where it's jumping in the timeline at any given point is right before the investigation begins of, like, who is the mole, he goes and gets a new pair of glasses. And so there's the only indication in any scene with him, really, of, you know, is this a flashback or part of the investigation is what is he wearing on his face?
Huh.
So, sorry, I know it's a much smaller thing, but the detail with jumping into the car for the epilogue, I thought was the same fundamental technique of, you know, before they made it explicit, sort of side detail of the environment and the props providing the time context you needed.
Yeah, they actually had really great attention to detail throughout this entire game in terms of all the dialogue options they recorded and actually having a response to when I pressed the A button when I was out of the coma, and the vehicles and everything.
Yeah.
So I think that matches their intention of having a very high respect for the details.
Mm-hmm. You know what one of my disappointments is, though? There weren't ever any more of those amazing billboards after the prologue.
Yeah, they were pretty cool.
Those are so cool. And they did so much to just initially set up this deeply. Like, everyone I showed that to went, oh my god, that's creepy. Like, totally unexpected at that point in the driving game. I thought they could have... They really stopped playing around with the creepy atmosphere. Like, they did stuff to unsettle you with the mechanics. But I love the billboards and the crows and stuff towards the beginning. And I wish those or other things had continued to be part of the cutscenes and the storytelling.
Yep. Man, how do these games ever make any money? Look at how many people got credited and contributed to making this game. Like, this game must have been very, very expensive. I mean, every video game is. Just incredible.
Well, if you're listening and you liked it, go buy a copy or tell your friends to buy copies too so that they'll make more like this. Oh, and you have put down your controller for upwards of 10 minutes. I see.
I know, exactly. The screen actually dims. Ugh, that's silly.
So here's a conversation I want to have, and I don't mind having it on camera, as it were, because I totally welcome suggestions. What do you want to do next once we finish all the content here in terms of games?
Yeah, that's an excellent question.
I would love to do something that has actual co-op gameplay. Don't know how many good options there are for that, but...
We do Gears of War 3.
What?
Gears of War. That one was pretty fun.
I have never played any of the Gears of War games.
Uncharted had a little bit of co-op. Mostly it was a single-player game, though.
Yeah.
What are some other great co-op games? What are you thinking?
I have no idea. Like, I don't really know... I don't know a wide variety of games. So
we could do a multiplayer racing game and just play through Burnout Paradise.
I suppose.
I'm kind of alright with getting away from racing games.
Yeah, me too. Don't want to, you know, shoehorn ourselves too much. Shoehorn. That's the wrong word. Typecast. No, that's not the right word either. What's the word I'm searching for here?
They both kind of work, though.
Yeah, there's something else. I don't know. Like, I know I at one point suggested... I love Crackdown, but I know you're kind of tired of it, and there's already been a really excellent co-op LP of it. And I was thinking we could do, you know, blind Crackdown 2, but I did not sense a whole lot of enthusiasm on your part for that prospect.
Yeah. I don't know, maybe. What was the other one that was... Oh, yeah, Saints Row. Same vein.
I have never played Saints Row. Is it a good game?
I don't know. I haven't played that much of it.
Does it have co-op?
It does, and it reminded me a lot of Crackdown.
Huh. Well, maybe we should investigate the possibility of a Saints Row... I assume you mean 2 or 3, since I haven't heard a lot of good stuff about the first one.
Yeah.
No. Yep, or, if you're listening still, God bless you, and if you have suggestions...
because you just love credits. How about Plants vs. Zombies? Has anyone done an LP of that? That'd be silly.
You know, I don't think anyone has ever done an LP of a Zynga game, period. That's PopCap. That's PopCap. I'm sorry. I don't think... I'll broaden it. I don't think
I've
ever
deeply offended many people, by the way.
Fuck them. Fuck anyone who has any emotional investment in games by either PopCap or Zynga, sparing the feelings of those who work for evil companies. I actually have a friend who works for Loot Drop, which is the company headed by John Romero that partnered with Zynga to make Peddington Park the G-plus exclusive.
How the mighty have fallen.
You know, I played for a while out of loyalty to my friend because he, put a lot of his time into it. And it's a cute game.
From the team that brought you Quake and Rage. Comes Peddington Park.
I mean, it's perfectly well made for what it is, but maybe we should do a casual game LP mix and match. I think there's a lot of interest in people seeing what, who've never tried Words with Friends and don't know the basic gameplay mechanics at work.
That's true. We could try Diablo or Torchlight.
True.
Maybe.
There's been a recent Diablo 2 co-op. I don't think there's been anything good with Torchlight, but I would have to check. But yeah, we could experiment. In another week or two, we're going to have our new computer. We actually did the... We almost built it, but the case didn't ship with the hard drive rails. So those are being shipped to us now. So hopefully soon.
Womp womp.
But it was really
Borderlands.
Cool. What?
We could do Borderlands co-op.
I'm not great at first person.
No.
I could try. It could be embarrassingly terrible. I mean, I guess it would be filmed from your perspective, so people wouldn't necessarily get nauseous watching my screen.
Although Borderlands is the same perspective as Crackdown.
Is it? I thought it was
first-person.
No,
you're right.
Shooter.
No, it's first person, you're right.
I think there is also, not that this rules out our doing it, so don't take it that way, but I think there was also one of those in the last year or so. But, I guess Borderlands 2, is coming out soon or just did, but there's a rule they gotta wait a certain amount of time before you do a new game.
Fair enough.
My problem with first-person games is I just get way too wrapped up in the first-person perspective and super tense, so I'm like, all sweating and jumping in my seat whenever an enemy comes on screen. I recognize that this is extremely embarrassing for me as a reaction to have, but... Or we could go old school. It was fun doing adventure games. We could always do a thing where, we could play an old school adventure game. Like, you've never done... There are a lot of old school adventure games don't make for very interesting LPs because
you don't want to talk over them.
Yeah, exactly. Like I was saying, you said you've never actually played Sam and Max, and that's a gaping hole in your gaming experience. But I don't. The joy of that game comes from the dialogue and everything.
Thought: Has anyone done Mirror's Edge? That game.
Yes, there was one of Mirror's Edge a while ago. I didn't watch it myself, but again, the fact that an LP exists does not mean we can't do one ourselves. I guess you heard me talk about games that make me nauseous and just started, you know, free associating from there.
Yeah, that's true. No, I busted out my game binder and was paging through it.
Or
did you ever play Beyond Good and Evil?
Oh my god, I love that game.
Yeah, that game was pretty good.
That's so good. There were motions a year or two back that they might have been developing a sequel, but I never heard anything.
I know. I even saw that really high-res trailer.
Yeah, the high-res trailer that showed absolutely nothing that would have to do with actual gameplay. Just like, hey, look, we made a 90-second short
movie
of those characters you remember. Okay, we're already at the, like, licensed software logos, and there's still 8 minutes left in this video.
Madness.
What? Seriously. What is possibly left?
I also want to point out that we've been listening to this song on loop for
Has
about
it been the same one looping?
Yes.
Oh my god.
For about 15 minutes, and not only is the song on loop, but the song only has about 2 lines that it keeps repeating.
At one point, we were on, I think it was a Delta flight, and it was an international one, so gigantic plane, tons and tons of people, and we had landed, and we were waiting to deplane, and it, you know, because of the amount of people, it took probably about 15, 20 minutes before we could get off, and we were just in our seats. The problem is they put on mood music, and this music had, I swear to God, one chord. It just played that chord, and the guy going like, over it, you know, sort of new agey. But that the little voice loop repeated every 10 seconds or so. Just one chord, one sample, 20 minutes. Jeez. It sounds like the trailer to the worst movie ever.
You know why this is going to take so long? There were at least 50 songs in this game.
Right now we're listening to Leaving the Fold, On You. You know how I know that?
How?
Because that's the only lyric in this song. Don't Give Up, that's your favorite.
Yep.
Northern Light Cocaine was the one they played over the opening cutscene, and it's really cool. I had not heard it before, and I genuinely like the song for itself.
Yep, fascinating.
So,
still trying to think of some good games to do.
Oh! So, I don't know why you sent me that list over text chat instead of just reading it out, because it's not like you have to worry about talking over any amazing content on screen. So I just recently, like in the past month, actually two weekends ago, today, exactly 2 weeks ago, I beat for the first time Portal.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. I was very proud of myself. I'm only 6 years late on this, I think. I don't know. But I still haven't played Portal 2 yet. I don't have good capture equipment on my computer, but have you already done the co-op campaign for that?
I have, but it was very challenging. It was long enough ago that I may not remember all the solutions.
Or we could do a thing where you're helping, but I have to solve the puzzles.
Yeah, sure.
That could be fun. Yeah, we continue our tradition of half-blind LPs.
Portal 2 was quite excellent.
That could be, I like that idea.
Yeah.
Co-op, where you'll record, but you don't get to help me solve the actual puzzles. And I'll go in totally blind.
Solving the puzzles is always my least favorite part of Portal anyways.
Oh, that's the best part. What, like the platforming?
No, the characters and the story and the dialogue.
Oh, well, okay, sure.
I just like being in the Portal world.
Yeah, I mean, the writing is completely brilliant, and everyone knows that, so...
I don't like having to use my brain.
I made the mistake of at one point watching an LP of like the first couple levels of the original portal, just like the first three or four test chambers. And it's amazing how much watching A Confident Solution spoiled a lot of the puzzle work for me. Like, in the later chambers, there was still some stuff I had trouble with, but, you know, I never got the experience of working out the basic mechanics and the physics for myself, and I'm now really disappointed I ever did that. But I've kept myself totally blind about Portal 2. So
would you want to play through the single-player campaign on your own?
Yeah, I'll play through single-player. I don't have any good way of... You know what? When I've got the new computer, I bet it'll be able to handle recording software and games at the same time. So maybe I'll record the first half and then we'll shift into... And we'll do the post-commentary, and then we'll shift into live commentary for the co-op.
Sure. That sounds fun.
Cool. We're also now, you know, continuing our tradition of deciding things about LPs live over, you know, final pointless videos.
Such as credits.
Yeah. Well, credits, driving around, ramming into cars. We like to make our decision process as transparent as possible.
And we like to torture our listeners.
Yep.
Wow, well, it's been 10 minutes of music credits.
If anyone's still listening, it's because they, for whatever reason, enjoy hearing us ramble. Like, no one's saying, you know, I really want to see these credits, and I wish those guys would just shut up.
Yeah.
Or, I love this song. I would like to have a clean 20-minute recording of it, but I'm not getting that here, I guess. Well, I've got a secret
We should put a code word. I'm going to put a code word here right now. The code word is watermelon. If you are the first person to post in the thread just the word watermelon all on its own, Matt and I will both comment on your post and grant you incredible accolades. Publicly for everyone in the thread.
You may be overestimating the honor of commenting on someone's post. But I support the idea that you generally propose.
I'm certainly not going to, like, you know, PayPal you $1.
No.
That would be way too
much
work.
You know what? We'll throw them a gift party.
Yes.
Oi. You know, the hell of it is, if someone did want to make a clean recording of this song looped for 20 minutes, all of these videos have commentary-less versions available from the OMG Spoilers YouTube channel.
YouTube page.
Yeah. So, you had to listen this far to find that out. I'm assuming here that if you're the sort of person who would attempt to record that song via the LP, you're stupid enough to not have looked there in the first place. So I'm, you know, being nice. It's a community outreach program to our less gifted audience members.
Gosh, as if the music credits weren't long enough, now we've got the car credits, and I'm sure that some of these automobiles required that their logo appear, while others did not. Wow.
You know, one major advantage that we can really appreciate about this video over the last time we were faced with this much dead air?
What?
You haven't heard word one about my couch.
Your sofa. I know. That's incredible. Well, one word at least, but not word two.
You repeated it. I guess you repeated the synonym. Does that count?
I don't know. We did it.
Oh my god.
We beat the credits.
there should
be real final boss fight.
there should really be an achievement for that.
All right. Well, join us next week when we hop into some multiplayer and some video challenges.
Sounds good.
Sweet. See you later.
Bye.